Reports say that heavy rains and flooding have killed at least 58 people in Tanzania, where you are, since the beginning of this month. What is the situation on the ground?
Thank you so much. Indeed, it has been a couple of weeks of havoc for citizens in different parts of Tanzania's regions like the Dar es Salaam capital, Zanzibar, Tanga, Morogoro, Lindi, and most of these coastal parts of Tanzania have seen heavy rains, of course, impacted by the El Nino phenomena, and a lot of debris and infrastructure damage. As you touched on, about 58 people have been killed over the last 2 weeks, and of course, the government spokesman revealed that this is one of the worst situations of you know, flood-related deaths in recent years. About, you know, these 58 deaths are a majority, obviously, women and children, and are caused by different scenarios. Some of them falling into sinkholes that are not visible because of the water. Some of them have been crushed under infrastructures. Some of them, the home that was once a place of solitude and a place of harmony for them, fell on them. Roofs falling on them. People dying in their homes and in their beds. So over these last 2 weeks, it has been a scenes of devastation, especially in these regions, because flood drainage systems are not adequately erected and are not adequately constructed. So it has been a situation of sadness in most part of this region. But even in the capital city, Dar es Salaam, where I am, there's been a lot of flooding, and in some parts of Tegeta, some parts of the city where you'd expect, you know, better infrastructure to deal with floods, has also seen a lot of flooding and a lot of destructions. So just last week, as you touched on, 8 children lost their lives when a bus fell into a gorge, of course, filled with water. Parents were doing interviews, saddened. We see fathers who had 2 or 3 children in the same school, in the same bus, witness their children lose their lives. And over the last couple of months, over 10,000 households have been affected. You know, 75,000 farms have been damaged by the flooding caused by these rains in coastal areas. And also, in last year, we CGTN went and covered a terrible flood, mudslides and floods in the Katesh region, Babati, where over 100 people lost their lives and saw severe infrastructure. And this obviously is affecting the Horn of Africa and the East African region because of the effect of climate change as well as El Nino. So it's been a compounded effect from last year, finishing with El Nino effects, and then climate change rains over the beginning of the year during this rainy seasons.
And Daniel, how are those affected dealing with the situation? And also, how is the government responding?
Well, so the communities are, of course, this is a new phenomenon. Over the last 10 years, heavy rains and flooding have been increasing in many parts of coastal Tanzania. There have been calls for communities that are living near these coastal areas to move and to higher lands. But obviously, because for many families, these are areas that, have been ancestral homes. Some of them have been, family has been there for generations. So it's difficult to move. Now, the government says once there's a break in rainfall, it will promptly address any of these submerged roads and sort of road infrastructure that have been identified by helicopter surveys, as well as those others that have not been surveyed as well. They will do a survey, and they say the aim is to find ways to fix these roads and bridges to prevent disruptions in sort of logistics and travel, as well as to ensure that once the rains come again, another season of rain, maybe after a year or whenever they come again, there will be infrastructure to be able to increase flood resilience in those areas. The government has identified certain areas of the country, and the tour area like the Msimbazi Basin in Dar es Salaam is also, in fact, today a big project to reclaim that area and create flood resilience infrastructure is underway. Houses are being demolished to ensure that citizens can make way for this improvement project. So the government says there's a huge infrastructure plan to fix damaged infrastructure from the rain. Citizens have been urged to now, be aware of climate change. It's something that for many Africans, they're seeing these changes, but not as aware of the issues and how it affects them. Now they're seeing different in rainfall patterns, they're seeing increased rainfall numbers and definitely deaths, as we've seen. So it is something that the government is taking seriously, but also citizens in different regions of Tanzania are likewise taking it very seriously.